first experience at the Mosconi Cup. Unbelievable. So amped over the year to get here. Really got a lot of support from my friends and my family, and getting to meet all these amazing people and be a part of something so big. It's really been a dream come true. As far as working with players and the juniors and stuff like that, really kind of upping my role in the world of pool is just phenomenal. Learning so much from Jeremy throughout the year, I feel like I've aged 10 years of wisdom. And just over this past year, you know, with the quarantine and everything, and talking to Jeremy every day and how hard of a year it's been, just learning so much is really where I feel like the improvement in my life has been. And you know, dealing with a lot of trash talk and going back and forth and you know, things that I haven't experienced as far as the competitive world. It's a different role as a coach, really helps me grow as a coach and as a player too. But being here, seeing, you know, with the different, not having the crowd and all of that, you know, it's obviously different than other years, which I wish I could have experienced, and hopefully will next year.
Yeah, of course, you know, playing Mosconi Cup was always my one of the best goals, one of the main goals in my career. After I won the World Championship, I kind of knew that I'm in the team, but I still wanted to qualify through points, because last year I was that close to be in the team and I lost in the last tournament. So I wanted to be on the team this year, and I qualified, luckily, because the tournaments, all tournaments were cancelled from March. And you know, when they announced my name in September, I was super happy. And of course I was happy that Alex is the captain this year, because I was practicing with him a lot and we're good friends outside of pool world. So I was super happy. And of course, I knew that with 4 wildcard picks, it's gonna be super strong this year. And it shows, you know, we're 8-2 up currently. And I think we're going to win. What else can I say? You know, my first day, I wasn't feeling super comfortable. You know, you can tell I was nervous. And I think it's logical, because I never played in this arena. Yesterday on day 2 I was feeling super comfortable. Not really because I was playing Corey, but you know, the feel of this arena is already here, so I'm feeling comfortable.
Hello, welcome to day 3 of Mosconi Cup. Let's say, talking about yesterday matches, we're playing really good, get some couple of good rolls, but we really came back to win a couple of tough matches and win all 5 matches in big lead from May 2. It feels good to have all these big lead, and you know, it's more relaxing for us, and we're really close to the win, and I think it's gonna be done today. Like, we're gonna go for the kill. And about the bubble, it's weird, you know, just, but at least it's a big stadium, so you can walk around, you can just switch rooms and do some other stuff, play some ping pong darts, and yeah, I mean, the team is awesome, a lot of fun, a lot of laughing, and good cooking from the captain, and yeah, we're having fun here.
So going into day 3, you know, yesterday didn't go as planned. Obviously we lost 3 hill matches that were super tough. Sky and I lost a doubles match. We came back from 3-1. We were kind of on the bad side of the rolls there in the first beginning of the match, and I don't really know what to say about that match. I mean, we broke and ran to go hill, and then after that they broke and ran, so there's nothing we could really do about it. We've had a lot of matches like that are super close, and just, it was just, you know, a few one ball made here and one missed ball there. It's just, you know, caused us the match. So I don't think we're losing any confidence, and I think that, you know, we're still confident going into today, and we're going to give it our best and see what happens today. You know, I think me losing that first point to Kachi in my first singles match was the big tide turner. I think if I make that, then the worst we could do was go down 3-2, but we have two, you know, matches after me that could win. We, you know, going into momentum and stuff, so, you know, I'm not saying I'm the reason that we're down, but, you know, it's a team game, and I think I played, you know, a part of it. So, you know, just things to learn from, and, you know, tune in today and see what happens.
First off, I want to say thank you to Matchroom and everybody for holding the Mosconi Cup. I appreciate all you guys, Emily and everybody behind it, and, you know, it's been great. Nick, my man Nick over here, Jake, everybody. Another thing, being in the bubbles kind of, it's, you know, it's different for me. I've never experienced this in my entire life, so it's a little bit of a, you know, experience that I'll remember forever. And, you know, everybody's staying safe and wearing their mask and doing everything possible that we can. And we're just having fun as Team USA in a bubble, I guess. But, you know, this ain't our bubble this year, don't seem like. But I feel like today we're going to come back and, you know, do some damage, hopefully. So another thing about these mullets that we got, these mud flaps, freedom flappers. Mine's a little wet right now. I just got out of the shower. me and Skylar came up with this brilliant idea in Vegas back in, I think, March. About these mullet deals, and kind of just looked at each other and was like, you won't grow a mullet. And I was like, man, you won't grow a mullet. And then next thing I know, he's like, I'll grow a mullet. And then we just start growing a mullet. We instantly went and got a haircut and got it cut into a mullet and just growed it out all the way to a Mosconi Cup. So it's kind of funny. I don't know, I think they're ugly really, but it's whatever. I ain't trying to impress nobody. But yeah, this has been a great tournament so far. Obviously, it's not been too great for us. Haven't had that much love or anything, but I just want to say thanks to Jeremy and Joey for picking me on Team USA, and we're going to fight. We're going to wear our heart on our sleeve and go out there and do our best.
It's presently day three, and we're not in the greatest position, but to talk about other things, you know, I'm very impressed with what Matchroom and this entire complex has done, putting the bubble together. I've felt very safe, really good with the rules, good with everything as far as accompanying us with everything we need. It's been really good to have some professional, you know, competition. Proper professional competition. We've all watched a lot of virtual pool this year, and I think Darren said it the other night online that it's just not the same. Even though it's fun to watch, but nothing like the real deal. Some live pool on TV on the biggest stage, of course, with no fans. You figure, what is the Mosconi Cup? But it was, so far, it's still been a great Mosconi Cup. You could still see the tension, definitely with the players. Maybe even more at times. So I appreciate my guys. They're gonna keep fighting. Not really sure what else to go over. Kind of makes me want to play again, I guess, a little bit more. I've said it the last few years, and I'll say it again, that it's much, much more difficult to be on the sidelines than it is to be in the box. But you know, it's been a great trip, and it'll continue to be a great trip.
It's a lot of pressure for these guys, and you know, my palms just sweat like crazy whenever they're out there. It's so hard to sit there and watch and see your boy lose when you have no control, but at the same time, you know, all I can do is be there for them and support, and growing a bond with these players is, I never thought that I would have with any of them. I mean, obviously we've all been friends, but now we feel like brothers. And Jeremy, me and him, never imagined how close that me and him will become. And through this experience, it's just been amazing. You know, Emily, she's a tough cookie, but I really know at heart she cares a lot about all these players and the event and all the people that are working it. It's obvious that they want to make pool better, and that's all of our roles. You know, trash talk and bull crap aside, at the end of the day, that's where we're at. I mean, we want to make pool better, and Matchroom is doing a great job of that. Other than that, I mean, I really, really hoping that we can come back today and make it to day four a little close and possibly maybe win. But you never know, you can't give up, and just enjoy the ride and the experience and learn from it. And there was a lot of positives and a lot of surprising things that came out of this, like that I wasn't really anticipating. You know, losing Justin was a real serious blow. I mean, having your chess pieces laid out and then losing a major one is always difficult. But the pleasant surprise, even though he lost a couple matches, but his play, everybody can agree, was right on point, was Chris Robinson. And I even told him last night, got a little bit emotional with him. I told him, you know, the way you've performed here has really, really solidified me and Jeremy's selection with you, and that me and him are capable of training players and convincing them that what we know is the right way to do things, and that Chris is the perfect specimen to improve. And being at a young age, he's got endless road in front of him. So this experience is amazing for all of us, and building that close bond and going from here into next year, just a major learning experience, and I'm super excited for next year.
Yeah, I think the week's gone pretty good. I think the start of the week there was a lot of trash talk and stuff like that and stuff going online, and you know, I used it as motivation. I think both teams played really well. There was a lot of crucial points that were 5-4, 5-4, 5-4. Then, you know, it could have gone either way. I think they didn't work on the lag as much as we did. We had a few competitions over the last month, and then in the practice room we were lagging a lot. And it was crucial, as you've seen. Every time it was hill-hill, I think, except from one match. I think it was Albin was playing doubles. All the breaking runs at 5-4 kind of won us those big points. I think the big turning point this year was we were working more as a team. We were doing a lot more drills. We were, you know, working as a team more and working on doubles play and trying to put the best lineups together as possible. And I think we did that pretty well. So hats off to Alex and Carl for doing that. And, you know, right now I'm just really happy to, you know, get the cup back to Europe. I'm happy that the fans choose me for the fans' choice. And I came out strong and I managed to win, and it was an incredible match. Shane played great too. Right now I'm feeling really good. I won the MVP. That's like an extra bonus for helping the team get the win. And I'm glad I came out there and showed everybody what I really mean and how good I can play under the big pressure. So, you know, it is what it is. We have a lot of beef, and it's squashed now, and I'm so happy for Team Europe.